SCORMs. A SCORM is a collection of activities that helps you practice your reading, writing, and listening skills on a computer. SCORMs can be found when you are learning something online. The word SCORM is only used for learning on a computer. Students will not have to use the word SCORM outside of their online course. You will find SCORM activities in your course. I'll scroll down and click on a SCORM activity. In this example, did you say Saskatchewan? There are often more than one activity. Many of the activities work in a similar way and are easy to use. To see a list of activities, I'll click on the drop-down menu at the top. In this example, there are 7 learning activities. I'll click on Exercise 1 to see a learning activity. If you are not sure how to complete an activity, read the instructions or ask your teacher. If you are doing an activity where there is more than one question, move to the next question by clicking the arrow button. When all questions are complete, click on the check button to receive your score. You will receive a score. In this example, 66%. You will lose marks for incorrect answers or asking the computer for help. You can review the activity again or even repeat it. Note that your score will show the average of your attempts if you retake it. After you receive your score, click on the OK button. When you are ready, choose the next activity from the list. When you are finished all of the activities in a SCORM, it is important to click on the Exit Activity link at the top of the SCORM. Your score will be saved in the gradebook. You can check your grade in the grade section in the navigation drawer. We can see all the scores here in the percentage column. Types of SCORMs. The SCORM activities may include reading or listening tasks. Some will involve typing. Using the audio player. Listening tasks will show an audio player with a play, pause button, the time and time length of the audio clip, a volume, mute button, and a download option. When playing, the time will count forward. This example shows that the audio clip is at the 4-second time of a 1-minute and 54-second clip. You can quickly move forward or backward in the audio clip by clicking and dragging along the time progress line. Moving to the right to move forward, and moving to the left to move backward. This is called scrubbing. You can mute the volume by clicking or tapping on the speaker icon. You can click and drag on the volume meter to the right to raise the volume and to the left to reduce it. Click on the 3 dots if you want to download the clip. Example number 1, listening and reading activity. With space to type answers, multiple questions. Example number 2, reading activity with sentence order. This is an activity where you click on words in the correct order to make a sentence. Example number 3, reading activity with matching. This is an activity where you click and choose from options in these drop-down menus. When you've made all the choices, click on the check button. Example number 4. Reading activity with paragraph reconstruction. This is an activity where you choose the sentence part that starts or goes next from the A, B, and C options. Example number 5. Reading activity with multiple questions. You read the paragraph, you read the question, you type your answer, you click on the check button, and then you click on this arrow to go to the next question. Example number 6. Listening activity with sentence reconstruction. Step 1. Listen to the audio. Step 2. Click or tap on the sentences to put them in the correct order to match the audio. When you think all of the sentences are in the correct order, click on check to check your answer. If you get stuck, click on hint to find out the next correct part. Example number 7. Listening activity with true, false, and other questions. Step 1, listen to the audio. Step 2, read the sentence. Step 3, click on true or false. Step 4, click on this arrow to move to the next question. The last example is example number 8, crossword activity. To begin, click on a number in the grid to see the clue or clues for that number. Read the clue, type the answer in the space provided, and click the Enter key to see the word in the activity. Complete the crossword, then click on Check to check your answers. If you are stuck, you can click on Hint to get a free letter. Note, you will lose points when you ask for a hint.